Our book today in the Thom Hartmann Book Club is The Black Panthers, Portraits from an Unfinished Revolution, edited by Bryan Shih and Yohuru Williams. This is from Chapter 1, In Defense of Self-Defense, Pathways to the Black Panther Party. People joined the Black Panther Party for many different reasons. The moment of politicization was different for everyone, but a few were commonly shared, including the 1963 bombing of the 16th Street Baptist Church in Birmingham, Alabama, and the 1965 Watts Urban Rebellion. A more general sense of frustration and alienation compelled others to join the Panthers' ranks. The party exerted enormous pull on the imagination of the members, especially those who had experienced police brutality. In the rebellious spirit of the times, the party's bold stance on self-defense resonated with those seeking fresh alternatives for achieving social justice and black liberation. Party members expressed a deep appreciation for other aspects of the Panthers program, including its community service programs, which grew out of a genuine love for the people. My neighborhood friend, a sister that I've known since I was about 11 years old, said, "Claudia, I want you to go with me. We're going to go and hear these Panthers speak at PS 92. Which was an elementary school in our community. I said, "Okay, I'll go, I'm down." I listened to these brothers speak and I heard the pitch. I saw the determination and I saw the compassion. I thought, wow, this is the feeling that I used to get when I went into clubs and popped my fingers and got on the dance floor. It was the same feeling, except it was bigger for me now. It was bigger than me. It was full of love of the people. No longer did we have to argue and fight about, "What are you looking at me like that for?" Or, "Don't step on my sneaker," or, "This is my block." Now we really had something to fight for. We had a people to fight for. This is bigger than any gang or club. We had a goal. We had something to look forward to, which was the betterment of black people. It was most definitely something that I was searching for, but I didn't yet know what that I was searching. I didn't find it. It fell on me. That was the first meeting. That's what actually started the wheels in my mind for me to become political. I was rank and file. I did a lot of things. The easiest way to say it is just to imagine worker bees. You got one queen, everyone else works. Rank and file, those were the worker bees. We did it all. The one thing I enjoyed the most was teaching the political education classes on 7th Avenue in front of the Harlem office. That was the most fruitful. But anything I did, it was for the love of the people. Wherever I was, wherever I was sent, or whatever I had to do, it didn't matter anymore because it was for the love of the people. We were trying to get the word out. If I had to sell 125 papers in a day and I got close to that goal, then I did a good job. I was originally from Queens and came out of the Corona branch of the Black Panther Party. When the Panther 21 were arrested and went to jail, in order to keep those offices open and functioning, Panthers were sent all over the city to Harlem. I was one of the Panthers that ended up in the Harlem branch. That's how I got to be there on Wednesday nights to give the PE classes, the political education classes. I was extremely nervous the first time, but once I found my voice, then it went like clockwork. A lot of the people in the community who were just walking by were like, "Well, let me stop and see what this little girl is talking about," because I was indeed a little girl at that time. We started off every PE class with a 10-point program, and we ended every PE class with, "Okay, let me hear from you guys. What do you want to see different in your community? And how are you living?" Then we would get the feedback, and then we would know how to concentrate our efforts. Rent strikes were crazy, because if you had to live like that, why should you pay rent? We did clothing drives. We did food drives. We did, of course, the breakfast program. There were a lot of other things that happened, and they might have been more meaningful, but those PE classes stayed with me. We were outside on the street in front of the office. When you were giving a class or you were having a talk inside the office and there were only Panthers around you, the feeling was just different than outside on the street. The Panthers knew what you were doing because they were Panthers and they were doing the same thing. Outside, there were constant questions and answers with the people. You had to give yourself up when you were outside in that crowd. You never knew who was going to say, "We don't care about that. We don't care about you. You need to go away." There were a lot of people that just did not know where we were coming from and were afraid that if they were seen in the office, or if they were seen asking questions, that they'd get reprisals, that they'd end up getting hurt. They were afraid. Things went so fast. Time seems to accelerate when you're always looking over your shoulder. At this time, it was all-out war against the Panthers, and brothers are being shot down in the street or set up or going to jail for years. We have brothers in jail since that time, 41 years. We've had brothers that we've lost on the inside that we can't let the world forget. The government said, okay, we're going to lock them up and throw away the key and no one will ever care. But it's not true. We want them out. We want freedom for all political prisoners. We don't want any more of them to die on the inside. That's the biggest injustice. There were times when our cadre consisted of almost nothing but women, and that was when the brothers were locked up or had to go underground. I remember being on a front line against a policeman on horseback and being 6 months pregnant. What we wanted was a simple street light, and we got the community out there and we blocked traffic. I didn't know whether I was going to be trampled, my baby killed, but I knew I had to be there. I was an active member of the party from 1968 to 1971, and in those few years, I aged 10, 15 years. We didn't have much time to be little girls. We went straight to womanhood. Talking about these things is bringing up all of these feelings, though I hadn't thought about or touched on them for a long time. It seems that as you get older and you look back on the things that you've done in your life, you say, oh my God, I could have gotten killed then. When you're young, fear is not really in your vocabulary, and once you look back, you wonder, why wasn't I afraid? We didn't have much time to be afraid. It was all about survival. The Black Panthers.